And we're backstage with Joel Rosen. And Joel, what is your role here with the company?
I am the production stage manager of the tour.
Oh, cool.
And I'm going to just take you around and show you a few things here backstage at the theater that are unique to our show.
Cool.
We're going to start here because we're nearby. This is the remote room for our horn section. Because of the intensity of the horn playing, it's very difficult. If the horn players are present in the orchestra pit, sometimes the live sound overwhelms the vocal quality of the show, and we're trying very hard to achieve a balance between the vocals of the show and the horn sound, the brass band sound, which was very much Elton John's intention as he wrote the music for it. He wanted to pay homage to that kind of music. So there's a lot of brass in the show, there's a lot of horns in the show, but they can't be present in the theater, so they're set up in a remote room. In this theater, it's on the third floor of the theater, which is fairly remote from the stage. Oftentimes we try to put it outside of the orchestra pit, but still nearby.
So how does that get, they obviously, I'm assuming they just hook it up and it goes to the board?
There's a snake of cables that runs from from the room,
and it goes through the building,
through the wall, and all the way down the stairs into the orchestra pit.
Cool.
Because of the number of quick changes in the show for our ensemble, who play multiple characters throughout the evening, we have what we call gondola areas set up on the stage. And essentially what these areas are is this is every costume piece, every shoe, every hat that any cast member is going to need during the course of the performance. And all of the costume changes throughout the evening are done here. This section doesn't encompass the whole company. It only covers part of the male ensemble. There are three other places in the theater where there are gondola areas.
Cool.
More gondolas over here.
Oh, yeah.
The male ensemble. The Billy dresser is over here. She has all of the stuff.
Oh, this is Billy.
For the various Billies.
Oh, wow.
That's here so that we have easy access to it.
And is this for all four of the Billies?
Yes,
are all in here? So
all four Billies.
And each one of them, obviously, they're all different sizes and stuff,
yep,
so they all have their own.
Each one has their own shoes, their own clothes.
No.
This is the calling desk. This is where I'm stationed during the evening. The show is called completely off monitor. There's four monitors here so that I can see the show. A color monitor, an infrared monitor. This is an overhead shot, which is especially important during the Dream Ballet when I have to look at the flying section of the show. And then there's a shot of the conductor so that I can see that. Who are playing Billy's are doing the beginnings of their physical warm-up.
And this is two of the boys that are playing Billy.
Who play Billy. They have a half-hour dance warm-up every day before they hit the stage just to get their bodies loose, make sure that they are physically where they need to be to perform a three-hour-long show that they are in 90% of, 95% of.
And we have, there are four Billies, so how often do they change? Are they like every 4 days?
Every single performance is a different, every Billy does two shows a week. So they're working, they're just warming up, they're doing their ballet moves, and then they will do a series of what we call safeties, which is the physical elements of the show that are more physically dangerous. We will do them as part of this pre-show warm-up section so that they have a chance to really limber up and make sure that they're feeling entirely comfortable with their own personal bodies and also with all of the pieces that they will be interacting with.
Cool. And who is that? That's
Adam Pelty. He's our resident choreographer. He is in charge of he's the artistic representative of the dance department. He's the one who makes sure that the boys are physically healthy and capable, and he is also their ballet teacher, so he's the one who continues to help them improve their skills.
You are?
I'm Chris Weir. I'm the head carpenter with the show.
Okay, cool. And what are we doing?
Right now,
currently we're in the half hour period before we get to safeties on stage. We'll go around and make any repairs and things like that to any of the lighting equipment or any of the scenic issues that we had the night prior. So we're kind of in that half hour period right now that we have to fix things before actors come on stage to do our safety rehearsal that we do.
This is part of the pre-show checks. Every night you have to make sure, you basically have to come in and make sure that everything is working.
Right.
You can't just assume that because it was working at the end of the evening before that it's going to be working at the beginning of the day. So they have to make sure that the wheels are all running on all the pieces. They have to make sure that the tracks are clean, that the floor is swept and mopped again. The lighting department has to go through and check every instrument that's in the air and out front, both conventional and moving, because any problems that occur the evening before get corrected the next day. And sometimes things happen, you know, when you turn on the rig, sometimes bulbs blow. So they have to check all that. The sound team has to make sure that all their computers are running, that all the changes for the show in the evening are programmed into the board, because it's a digital board. And then they have to check that each individual speaker that's hung around the building, all of them are functioning in top shape.
There's a lot. Do you know how many light fixtures you guys have in a show like this?
Off the top of my head, I'm not 100% sure. I know there's something like close to 50 automated fixtures overhead, just alone. And then there's a supplement of side light fixtures, and then a good amount of front house as well. So.
And I see that there's a lot of movement going on back here with these flies and things.
We have. At the end of the first act, we have a number called Angry Dance, which we also nicknamed the Riot. And Angry Dance is each of the members of the ensemble has what we call a barricade, which are these large wooden pieces that are currently being thrown out. We bring a couple of them in during pre-show because we have to do pre-show safeties with the actors. So we need the pieces that they touch for that. So that's what they brought in the barricade container so that we can use the actual pieces. But during the show, this area of the stage, these units, these trucks we call them, travel back and forth. So there's no room for these pieces to sit on the deck. So they have to store them in the box and fly it out.
Is that something that's unique to us because we have a small backstage area? Do you guys play in some theaters where that doesn't have to go up in the air?
Only rarely.
Okay.
It's very rare for us to have enough of a footprint to be able to avoid that. So,
cool.
Right. Now, in the theater here, due to the limited amount of space, it is much further on stage than normal. Normally, they can fly it without having to move these trucks on and off stage, but because of our spatial...
Other things that are flown out there, the big Maggie Thatcher. on the other side. Well, it's the same deal on the other side.
Cool. Well, thanks. That's cool.
Sure, no problem.